Dr. Walensky, I used to have the utmost respect for the guidance from the CDC. I always considered the CDC to be the gold standard. I don't anymore. And I want to give you three examples where I think the conflicting, confusing guidance from your agency has undermined public confidence and contradicts the scientific guidance of many experts.
I kind of wish we got to hear all three of those, but you get the idea. You have Senator Collins saying that that she no longer thinks the CDC is the gold standard. And to that, I just respond, yeah, you shouldn't have thought that for about the last 9 months. It has really been clear since last summer that the CDC is run by Democrats who are neurotic mediocrities, playing politics, covering for the teachers' unions, giving absurd guidance that is has the effect of law. I hate this term guidance. They are making laws because the federal government turns to them, the executive branch turns to them and says, okay, what do we do? And they go, well, you know, we're just giving you the guidance. I mean, it has the effect of law. It's like a rulemaking agency, which there are many of in the federal government, that can come up with some, you know, Fish and Wildlife can say, well, this is the determination we have about, you know, how many salmon you can catch this year. And if you mess it up, they can arrest you, right? I mean, there are federal agencies that have effectively criminal rulemaking authority, you know, or they can make you into a criminal if they want. The CDC has taken it upon itself to be effectively the COVID pandemic super legislature. So I just think it's disingenuous when they pretend, oh, yeah, you know, we're just giving you our ideas. They know that's not true. They know that the federal government's going to do exactly, especially this federal government, the Biden administration is going to do exactly what they say. And they'll give the Biden administration what they want, which is just more. They want to feed into the pandemic paranoia more. They want to feed into it. Well, we're all seeing now these people are nuts. I mean, I really do believe that Fauciism has turned into a mental illness, that people have become so riddled with anxiety that they can no longer be counted on to be reasonable, to be thoughtful, to make their own decisions, because they're just, oh, my gosh, what does Fauci say? Does Fauci say I can hug someone? Does Fauci say I can hug? I mean, you need Fauci to tell you whether it's safe to hug somebody? In the UK, you know, they're actually just being told in recent weeks, you know, you can hug people. In Canada, they'll arrest you if you try to have a church service that doesn't respond to or that doesn't comply with the arbitrary COVID guidelines. So there are other places in the world where this has been a real problem, and people should think differently about the government going forward. You, as a patriot, as a law-abiding, God-fearing, and I know there's atheists who listen to the show too, and, you know, God bless, but as a law-abiding person and citizen in this country, you should be armed, okay? I think now we're getting to the point where everybody should understand that you should enjoy your Second Amendment rights and exercise them. This government going tyrannical at some point in the future, which is the whole purpose of the Second Amendment, as we know, the government going tyrannical is something that you should not dismiss out of hand as an absurdity. Not that you do, but more than ever, I think people have seen, huh, really? The government thinks it has the right to arrest people for gathering with their own family and friends in a private home because the government says so. They did in Oregon. They did in parts of this country. They do in Canada. They do in the UK. I'm going to arrest you, going to take away your freedom because you want to be with your family members because they say it's not safe. It's not safe. Yeah, the authorities, those same authorities did such a good job handling this pandemic, didn't they? You should have contempt for the CDC and for Fauci. That's what they deserve. If this was a war, they lost battle after battle. And now finally, it seems we may have exhausted the enemy, or maybe the enemy's exhausted our reserves. And so we're approaching the end of this thing, but nobody could say that our response to this was a success. And what do? They blame you. Oh, you didn't mask up enough. You didn't social distance enough. Yeah, as if that was really some great pandemic ender. No, they overstated this all along because neurotics needed some emotional crutch to think that we could control this. We can stop the virus. I remember last summer in California, New York, when people were saying, oh, see, we wore masks, so we took care of this. It's not how it works. Back to Senator Collins in this hearing yesterday on Capitol Hill, speaking to Walensky, who's almost as bad as Fauci, and how CDC sucks up to teachers unions because the CDC is a, just like so many other federal agencies, a bunch of Democrat deep staters. Play 12.
So here we have unnecessary barriers to reopening schools, exaggerating the risks of outdoor transmission, and unworkable restrictions on summer camps. Why does this matter? It matters because it undermines public confidence in your recommendations, in the recommendations that do make sense, in the recommendations that Americans should be following.
Yeah. If you are a rational, reasonable person who is paying attention, you don't trust the CDC's guidance anymore, because you shouldn't. Even Bro Cuomo over at CNN starting to see this. Play 10.
The New York Times reporting that the CDC's numbers on the risk of catching COVID outdoors are misleading at best. What does that mean? Well, we've been working on the assumption that, quote, less than 10% of transmission happens outdoors. However, it is just as likely that the transmission percentage is less than 1%. Why? Why didn't they update it? Is this about them big brothering us?
Yes. The answer is yes. Come on, come on, Bro Cuomo. Come on over into the side of truth and reasonableness on this one. I don't care about all your other stupid statements. I don't care about our political disagreements. I don't care about, you know, the fact that you cover for your brother and all that. On this issue, the more the merrier. The CDC didn't want people to realize how absolutely bleeping stupid it was to have anybody masking outside ever. So they didn't update the numbers. And I was right, and they were wrong the entire time. Yay.
Hey, Team Buck, thank you so much for watching The First on YouTube. If you like this video, please click that little thumbs up button so then it will log as liked. And also, if you want to see more great content from The First, please click subscribe.